You two know each other.
We do know each other in sort of a way, but I guess there's more of a way.
I'd like you to meet your sixth cousin.
What a day that was. You may remember 2 years ago a series of reports I produced called Heritage. Volunteers at the Lancaster Mennonite Historical Society researched my family roots as part of Lancaster County's 300th anniversary. It was quite an eye-opening experience. And ever since then, like many of you, I have become obsessed with genealogy. Well, now there's a new way to discover your family's history in a way you never imagined. Some call it genealogy to the extreme. It's DNA testing, and it's possible right now.
This is a genealogy to the extreme because it has the potential to rewrite the first chapter of every family history book.
Many pride themselves on knowing family roots. 2 years ago, I discovered I am a 10th generation Lancaster Countyan on both sides, a descendant of Pennsylvania pioneers Peter Lemon of Switzerland and Peter Pickle of Germany. Both arrived in the Susquehanna Valley in the early 1700s. While that might be impressive knowledge, it's not enough for this man.
Because each group has its clads and subclads within it.
Darvin Martin is a nationally known and recognized expert on DNA genealogical research. He says while it's nice to know your family tree, you must discover your place in the world family tree. And more important, you must discover something called your haplogroup.
Everybody traces to a common male ancestor in East Africa between 60 and 70,000 years ago. The different haplogroups have different migratory paths back to that ancestor.
Haplogroups are the people you link up with through DNA, the chemical blueprint in your body. Through a simple DNA test taken by my father, I have discovered I am part of haplogroup R.
The R group is very common in Europe, in Switzerland, like your family is from, but also in Western Europe, in France, and in the British Isles.
Because of DNA research, I now know that my people, the R group, migrated from East Africa into Pakistan, northern India, Asia, and eventually Eastern Europe more than 70,000 years ago. And I also discovered some of my co-workers, Mike Hostetler and Lori Burkholder, share an almost identical DNA makeup with me. It's fascinating stuff and readily available to anyone. DNA is most commonly traced through a male ancestor because of the presence of the Y chromosome. Testing is a three-step process that begins with a painless swab of the mouth. The swab cells are placed in this vial and then mailed off for processing. When the results arrived in the mail, like they did for my father, they are ready for interpretation and the discovery of your ancient family tree.
This shows how people are intricately related to one another in ways that we could not have determined otherwise.
Now, I should mention that DNA testing is not inexpensive, but for some people, it is well worth it. The Lancaster Mennonite Historical Society can provide you with a kit and complete the testing and the analysis for $300. It's also available online on sites like FamilyTreeDNA.com and Ancestry.com for about $150, but that does not include the interpretation that people like Darvin Martin can provide. And I should mention that Darvin is from Brownstown, Lancaster County. He's a chemist and a great guy and an expert on all of this.
Kim, how popular has this DNA testing, genealogy testing become?
Well, for people who are into their family roots, this is the next step. Somehow it's not enough anymore to know who your great-grandmother was or your great-great-grandmother. You have to know your haplogroup.
It's fascinating that
it's
something
great?
We can do now.
Yes,
to find out
and who knows where all of this will lead.
Right. Okay. Thank you, Kim.